In the past year, our vocabularies have shifted in reflection of a collective need to protect ourselves and each other. Before 2020, we knew the words social and distancing, but rarely heard them used in direct succession. While it gained importance in the medical world in 2003 to slow the spread of SARS, it was not originally coined with that meaning. In 1963, it was used by Edward T. Hall, a cultural anthropologist, in his study of proxemics, which considered how we use space and what effects density and closeness has on us. For Hall, social distance was about the comfortable zone for interactions between acquaintances, about 4 to 12 feet. Farther than the space we are comfortable sharing with our partners and friends, but closer than with those we don't know. At the same time here in Peterborough, Ron Tom was designing Trent University. I've heard stories of Ron hiring research assistants to go out and look for people having great conversations, and then once they left, to rush over and measure the distance and the relationship of their chairs. This information was then compiled, studied, and used in the furniture layouts of Trent's original common spaces to encourage vibrant and meaningful exchanges between students. Physical closeness, being near other humans, especially humans we like, is nourishing. As the epidemic became a pandemic, this phrase was replaced with physical distancing to better articulate that while there is room for social interaction, physical separation was the necessary measure. Continuing our mini tours of presently, we're looking at works that consider separation through distance, isolation, and physical barrier. Come with me.
This is Same Difference, Windsor, Detroit, by Nadja Pelkey. It's a black and white photo series that she took in 2020, so after the border closed between Canada and the States. What's interesting about this photo series and the way that it's installed is that it kind of does the work of erasing that border. It's really hard to tell which is which because the water and the sky are the same. The buildings are very recognizable. Borders are really interesting weird things because they're these strong lines that also don't exist. The water doesn't care, but we can block or at least restrict the way that people move across them. Another thing I love about this photo series is that they're stickers. So she's printed these photos on what's called photo text fabric. So they're actually these beautiful, big, single, peelable stickers. This work is called Dissolving States, and it's by Jordan Dunlop. I love this work because it's beautiful. It's playing with color and texture in such interesting ways. What's special about the way that Jordan's made this is he's actually used, instead of any conventional flat plane like a canvas or paper or anything like that, he's actually used salvaged acrylic panel. He's painted on the front and the back. So everything that he's painted on the back all of a sudden becomes perfectly smooth and shiny. It's also a little bit behind everything that he's put on the front. So all of the paint that's on the front has this texture. You can see his brushwork, you can see the paint, you understand it as this physical thing. And it actually is a physical thing. It casts a little bit of a shadow because it's a little bit in front of that layer on the back. So, it's gorgeous, great colors, really interesting use of material, but also we're using plexi everywhere as these physical barriers. So, to us, in the context of this show, it makes so much additional sense. These works by Teri Donovan are incredible articulations of the loneliness we're all feeling right now. They were made in 2017, but certainly it's something that humans have understood for a long time. What she's done in order to create this feeling of a figure trapped inside a box is really pretty impressive. So she's got photos of figures, and then within and behind this semi-transparent acrylic top, she's placed that image at different levels. So We can even see and feel the weight of that figure leaning and pressing on the front plane. Got the hand right up against the glass, the arm, the head, and then the body slopes backwards so you can really understand that weight, that longing, that exhaustion, that weariness. This is 6 feet, a wooden platform painted black. It's by Jessica Hanzelkova. This is a really interesting work because it's actually kind of a pivot. This was made in January 2020, and it was made as a stage for a performance about physical distance. Now we've got physical distancing measures, and if you consider that this work is 12 feet in diameter, then half that, about 6 foot radius. That means that if you put a body in the center, they're perfectly spaced to protect themselves with that 6 foot physical distancing barrier. That's